Hello, and welcome to a short ARM CMSIS tutorial. Recall that CMSIS is a C-based software abstraction layer for the Cortex-M series of ARM processors. Assembly is good, but only in very specific circumstances. CMSIS is good pretty much in all circumstances. It's just not as fast. That being said, it takes quite a bit longer to program in assembly than it does to program in CMSIS, as this example will show you. The first step, as always, is to create a new folder and a clean project. I named my folder CMSIS folder. If you need help setting up a project, I have a previous video which covers this. Nothing is out of the ordinary until I start including files. Next, I find my Kyle folder and go into the ARM, Device, ARM, and ARMM3 folders. In here you will find two folders, Include and Source. This contains CMSIS. Copy these files and place them in your project folder that you just created. Be sure to place them next to your project files. Next, create a main.c file and add it to your project. You don't need to add anything to the file just yet. Next, navigate inside the pasted include folder, change the file type search to all, and add the startup arm cm3.s and system arm cm3.c files. These will be the files that will be run on startup and will initialize CMSIS for you. Your project tree should now look like this. Here's where I go a bit quickly. I have some code pre-written, so I just paste it into the file. As you can see, the uncommented code is only 10 lines long, so you can just pause the video and copy it down if you wish. I also have a GitHub link below if you wish to see how the assembly looks against the C, and how much more code it takes in assembly to do the exact same thing you do in C. Here I am just doing the final configurations for the project. Again, if this is unusual for you, or you have not seen this before, I have previous videos which cover this topic. One final additional configuration, though, is the fact that you have to include the path to the include file folder. By doing this, it can access the armcm3.h file and run the full initialization for you. After this, you should be able to build, run, and load your file. The unfortunate part of this is that, unlike assembly, I won't be able to show you exactly what's going on in each register all the time. However, you'll just have to trust me that this does what it says it does.